The Fox Luca è sharper trades. The market is stabilizing, at least for now, is stabilizing above the 233 support. Now, this is an important area, needs to hold any move below today low and yesterday low, especially 228.02. This thing is going to go south. Market is taking into consideration all the issues, most of the issues that this coronavirus is causing into the global economy. And but you know, there's also a lot of uncertainties, and so this is indecision, 2 days of indecision, a spinning top followed by another spinning top. Now the upper volume today picked up a little bit smaller than yesterday. So this is struggling between the 247 and 233. What we need to see is a move above 247, hold, and then at that point we have a shot to retest the 80MA and then 260. This is a key resistance, triple resistance. And I think at that point it's gonna roll over. If he gets there, he'll roll over. But if he breaks the upside, then we have 273, 287, and 300 as the next resistance areas. Nevertheless, one day at a time, in the after hour market, this thing is down. Shift inside the 1 minute chart, this is what's happening. Big upper shadow, all the way up to 287. This is institution getting ready for, I think, the next move to the downside. And then some lower shadows, I mean some upper shadows, and pressing down. There is a big upper volume, 2.5 million shares that just came in. No, wait, 3.3 million share, one block order. This is significant. This is gonna make some kind of a move tomorrow. This single order will force some kind of move. We don't know. We don't know which direction. Right now it's an indecision and it can go either way. So let's see, if it breaks below the 237, 233.77, then we got a problem. It will retest yesterday low at 228 and then below that restarts this falling channel, 221 and then 209. The picture is not pretty at all by any means. Let's see, I was hoping, not hoping, but you know, I will expect at least some consolidation and a little bit of bounce. I mean, this thing came down 30% in a month, 3 weeks, a month. So some kind of move to the upside is necessary. It's just right now, today we didn't get it. We'll see if it comes tomorrow in the next few days. NDX a little bit better. The body of the candle is a little bigger. Now there's a longer upper shadow that came near the 80MA. So this one, like you see today low, it's closing above yesterday, 2 days ago and 3 days ago low. So that's important. The NDX looks better than the SPY. For this one, let's look if we retest the 80MA and then this channel top. And if it gets there, maybe it will extend to the red line, the 200 simple moving average, currently 8100. In the AWM, this is the inverse ETF for the Russell 2000. A little bit of a consolidation, but 2 days of indecision. And for this one, the 80MA, it's all the way up here to 113. So we might retest it tomorrow, I'll say. This one looks better with the support holding above 95. And the Dow Jones Industrial better also. It's below the 20, so it's holding the 20,000. That's important. Yesterday came down to 18,917. Today the low was 19,177. So indecision, yesterday longer shadow, today not so much. And for this one, it needs to come back above 2050, 2500, and then next targets 21 and 22, 21.3 and 22. Anyway, there's still, obviously the pressure is still there. We just don't know how much, when it's gonna increase or pick up again. Or if this bear step aside for a few days, and give the Bulls a chance to at least catch some breath. Because right now, underwater, folks. Well, let's take a look at the individual stocks. We traded today as day trades, and then some of the swings that are working. AHPI, this is one of the swing and virus-related stock. It's working very well. Yesterday made a move to that, popped, reached the target at 22.46, extending, came as high as 27.81. For this one, folks, you want to trade the rising channel. Let's see, the 15-minute chart. Broke, okay, so broke this channel. Let's see the hourly chart. Yeah, same. So now this one broke the channel, and so as a profit taking today's, and it's holding the support at 23. This is our primary support. Secondary support is 18. Below the breakout area of yesterday. Here a good looking chart from the daily point of view, breakout, volume is steady, but you know, those virus related stocks, folks, move very quickly. So it's easy to get stopped out. It's easy to be caught on the wrong side of the trade. For this one, again, the chart is still good looking, but you know, expected that if it pulls back, it will move not just $1, 3, 4, 5, 10, 15. Okay. Just be aware of that, because from 27 to today low, 20, that's $7. So if you trade those things, small position. Next target, 31.87. If he gets there, the next resistance, 44.23. When he gets there, if he gets there, closer position. Big resistance. APRN, Apron, this was a fantastic day trade 3 days ago, a beautiful day trade yesterday, and then today an extension up to 27, then a major reversal. Now, this is a Dragonfly Doji, but if I look at the 1 minute chart, it doesn't match the price action. Because as you can see, big steep rollover, that's the lower shadow, and then a weak bounce, where this one shows, the daily chart shows that it went all the way up to 24, incorrect. It went all the way up to 18, or 16. So this is closing right here. So I'm not sure why TC2000 is showing this kind of candle. The red candle will be all the way down here, 16, 20, 16, 30. So this is done for me. Beautiful day yesterday, an extension today. If you held the position, take your profit. This is done. BA, struggling. So we attempted to catch this bounce, came down 94% in a month, 3 weeks a month, speculating on a possible bounce. We're not getting it. I mean, there is indecision yesterday and today, and closing below 100. So for this one, the line in the sand is 89. Today made a little higher, it has 90.35, and then moved up a little bit. But it's closing below 100. In the after hour market, it's done 95. This is a primary support. Hard to say, it's an indecision. When you have indecision, it can go either way. After a 94% drop, I will expect some kind of bounce, but again, this is just a speculation and we are not seeing a buy signal quite yet. So keep an eye on this one, but again, 89 is the support area. If it moves above today high and holds 104, that was the resistance yesterday in the after hour market, that's where it was, 104 right there, 104.77. Looking for 114, 133, and 153. We'll see. Huge sell-off. I mean, look at this massive volume. When you have this kind of massive volume, either on the upside or downside, is this, in this case, is on the downside. This is everybody jumping ship. That's when institutions come in. So we'll see. TODX. This one is struggling. There are more red candles than green. That's never a good sign. It pops, as soon as it pops, drops, pops and drops, pops and drops. It's interesting that it sold in the closing price of 3 days in a row. Tuesday, it was 10.68. Wednesday, 10.70. Thursday, 10.60. So it sold in the area. So that is the, you can call it the primary support. And then the secondary support, it has to be this low at 8.20. I mean, that's $3 further. So I'm not comfortable with that personally, but if you are, fine. This is one of the virus related stocks. Technicals are bullish, but now as you can see, the OBV is starting to point down. So this is always cause for some concern. And the money stream, it's looks like it's moving lower a little bit. So I'll be careful with this one. And several times it tested the 1430 and it was unable to break it. So that's obviously big resistance. And that's why we're seeing this possible pullback or reverse. Gild is impressive. I mean, it's all over the place and can make it difficult to trade. That's why I think the best way to trade this one is using the hourly chart. So what it did today? Today popped, reached my target 83.52, came as high as 86. Now this company is in the spotlight. They basically is the only company that has a drug that could effectively treat the coronavirus. And I was mentioned several times, even today during White House press conference. And the company is testing 5 different trials in different regions. So they're working very hard. We don't know. Right now, this is a sell signal with the upper shadow and a big number volume increase, 46 million for the shares. But again, there's a lot of manipulation because, you know, this company is a hot company right now, dealing with this major crisis. So the support is 77 and 72, 73 yesterday low. Again, the way you want to trade this is use the hourly chart. Trade the rising channel. When it reaches the channel top, close the position. When it pulls back, see what it does in the channel bottom. If you see a buy signal, like right now we're not seeing it. If you see a buy signal such as a hammer, okay, or an engulfing, I don't see that, or a piercing signal, any of those candlestick pattern with some good volume, sorry about that, with some good volume, then it's a buy opportunity. Right now, it's testing the 50 simple the moving average it's holding, so that's, you can think of that as the secondary support down at the blue line. Back to, let's see, yeah. So I was looking at the board number one. On the board number two, which is the one that makes more sense those kind of stocks that move very fast, the volatility, the virus related stocks, and currently the indexes, because they move so much. This was my target, 84, 87. And it's all the support. I mean, I like the look of it, but again, number of volume increase, and then we'll have to see what it does. Grail, this was a day trade. The 3 day trades we took today worked briefly for the first early part of the morning. The very early part of the morning, and then that's it. Not my favorite at all. In fact, those are very dangerous if you don't get out in time. So I don't like those kind of day trades, but you know, you take what you can. So this one consolidated at 4, and then made a rally from 4 to 4.75. And that was a big move. If you get rid of all this mess that came after that, there it is. So from 414 to 475, that's almost a 20% move. A consolidation, and then here, when you have this kind of consolidation, the VWP needs to hold as well as the moving average. It fell immediately, And this was the first break. We had very tight stops, 440 and 420. Took up both right there, one and then two. And then this thing imploded, went all the way down to three. When you day trade, folks, keep those stops. Day trade, you can make a lot of money, you can lose a lot of money. So when you trade an enter position as a day trade, use those stops. Don't just hope that the thing will turn around, because those are very volatile that we're using. And they can make a lot of profit going up, but if they reverse, and they will not recover. Those are pop and drop kind of stocks, okay? So be very careful. Follow the guidelines and use the stops. IFMK, this was another one that worked very well right at the opening. Major consolidation and a big pop in the pre-market. Look at this. It ran from one yesterday and then this morning to three, two sixty. Steep consolidation. And then a drop right at the opening on a huge volume. Consolidated around two. And then started rallying from two to cut the VWP, the moving average, and ran. Ran to, my target was 288, came very close to that, 283, and then a steep pullback, which was to be expected. Consolidation held briefly the moving average, then rolled over very hard, down to two. Now this one, we had super tight stops, 250 or 240 and 220. And then got stopped out. And then, and what it did after, was a consolidation, a pennant formation for several hours, and then it needed to break out there. There was a big resistance at 235 and 248. He wasn't able to break it, did a head fake, and then rolled over. From that point on, he went down. Brief recover, and then in the aftermarket down. So this is done, nothing else to do with this one. Lake reached the target today, a little bit of a pop. An analyst, so the target was again, board 1863. Today made a high of 1880. An analyst gave a target of 22. Our targets moving forward, volume is good if it extends 2060 and 2273. Support 16 and 14. I'm kind of tentative to do 15, but because of the volatility of this one, you know, put it into consideration where if you trade this kind of stocks, that is the volatility. They produce a lot of movement to the upside, but you gotta be prepared for also possible reversal. So yeah, 16 and 15. Yeah, I'm not comfortable with 14, too low. 16 and 15. Myrna is all over the place. A big pop today came near my target of 35.94. That was my third target. 34.98. I think this is done for now. Number volume increased today. There was several comments about this company. They're working on the vaccine and most likely they make it, but it will take 1 year to make it. So that's why I send this mark the price down, right? This rollover big time. You know, 1 year. That's how long it takes, at least 1 year to 18 months to make vaccines. So anyway, for me, this is now done. I reached my three targets and we'll keep monitoring because it's an important player in the current fight to the coronavirus. So we keep watching it, but that's it. This is done for now. WTRH, this was another, the third day trade that worked briefly, first part of the morning, and then rolled over. Again, not my favorite. In fact, I don't like when they do that, but you know, you take what you can. This one consolidated during the pre-market. Nice, steady, was very strong, in fact. Yesterday and in the aftermarket and the pre-market, lower shadows, pop, VWP held nicely. And then as soon as he opened, he started to rally. He rallied with a big, trade share at the opening, big rally to reach the target. My target was a little higher to start, I think it was 460, something like that. So it came to 440 pull back the test. So that became the resistance. Tested again, and then a Dunbar volume came in. I mean, a red candle came in, started to make a lower high, and then took out this support right here at 380. With this one, we had two stops, 360, 390 and 360. So they were both very, very tight. When this one, folks, this one ran from 320 to 430. That's a 50% move. Oh, 40% move. Take the profit. If you happen to trade this thing, you have 40% in this kind of crap market. Take the profit. And then it pulled back, it retested the VWP, and then a major rollover, big dump down to 280. Got a little bit of a bounce. If you didn't exit the position here because you thought it was going to go higher, when you have this kind of move and then the thing halted, it's going to bounce. Sell on the bounce. So the bounce came all the way to the VWP, fell miserably, and then rolled over, and this one imploded, went all the way down to 2. Before attempting a little bit of a recover and then weakening into the close. After our market at 270. Nothing else to do with this one? Again, folks, those are day trades. Don't hold them overnight, unless they close well. If they close well, Apron did yesterday or the day before, more like the day before, then sure, it's risky, but you know, like today, I wouldn't hold it, obviously. WTRH, this is not a good close. I mean, sure, it's holding a support too, but this came from zero at 29 cents. This is crap, right? So anyway, this is the support. If you're, for some reason, if you're still holding it, a 2 is the support. Zoom, beautiful, worked out very nicely, reached my second target. At that point, I said, peel some off or take some profit. Folks, with this kind of market, take the profit. Look at the thing, broke out yesterday, reached first target today, 121.96, and reached the second target, 130. So if you enter yesterday around when I sent the message, 114 right there, 13%, folks. Take the profit with this kind of market. Now, there are chances that this will go higher. Everybody's now using Zoom to work, to connect, to do things, business. So I'm looking for 139 and 151. Would you re-enter this position? It looks good, but it could pull back. In the after hour market, it's down at 125. So it's right there. It depends what the market does. It's a hot company, but if the market goes down, it could take down this one as well. So we'll see. Right now, reached my second target. I'm happy with that. The consolidation is good. Any pullback, so now we are tightening stops. Please refer to the message I sent you. Right now, I don't have the list in front of me. I have to say 119 and 1 and 111, 119 and 111. So basically today low and near yesterday opening price. Well, folks, that's it for today. We'll see you tomorrow. Good trading. It's Friday. See what happens.